I recently discovered this incredible feature inside of Fillout's form software. It allows me to build a form that integrates with Calendly, which essentially means that I can ask people to schedule time on a calendar. But most importantly, what I'm getting when this form is received is one submission with all of the information. Now, this is really important because very often what we might have in the past is created essentially two separate pieces to this puzzle. One part where we have a form and then ultimately we ask people to fill out time with us on a Calendly or other calendar link, and we don't actually know how those pieces tie together because they don't initiate from the same point of origin because of the fact that we've strewn them together with multiple tools. But now I'm happy to say that we can do all of this directly inside of Fillout. And I'm gonna be walking you through exactly how to get that set up. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Fillout is one of our absolute favorite form softwares. It integrates with all of the no-code tools that we love to use. It integrates with Airtable, with Smart Suite, with Make, with Zapier. It talks to everything out there. And on top of that, it's just a really good form software, as I'm gonna be demoing here today. Now, if you don't already have Fillout, I would first ask that you follow along while watching this video, and you can get started with your free account by using our link below. Now, before we get into the actual heart of things, I also want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you're new to no-code automation, it might seem a little overwhelming, but the fundamentals are actually pretty straightforward, and I teach those in my free automation training. Grab the training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll include links wherever you found this video. But for now, let's hop on into it and get into how we can move forward with this. I'm gonna be creating a new form from scratch inside of Fillout. And you'll see that with any Fillout form, I can choose to automatically connect it to my data source, in my case, Airtable, or I can just start with a blank form or a template form. Well, in our case, because I want this information to go directly into Airtable, I'm gonna set it up right like this. I'm building an Airtable form. And it's that simple. I've already integrated my Airtable account, although I might still be reminded about that integration on the next page. For now, I get to pick my theme. I will go with plain because I am boring, and I'll move on to the next screen where here it is. It's gonna ask me for that Airtable connection, which thankfully I already have, and I will click next. Now it's gonna ask me for my base. I created a base called Fillout Example, and I can search for it like this and find it. And inside of my base, I only have one table. You'll see it load here in just a moment. It's my application table. Make that selection, and we're gonna create our form. Now I'm gonna go in step by step and actually build this form out, but before I do that, I wanna really quickly flip over into Airtable, because in Airtable, I wanna share with you what this looks like. Inside of my database, I've got a first name and a last name and an email address, and I'm asking a question on the form. And then presumably, if they're a good fit, like I'm imagining that they're filling out some sort of application and we say, hey, yeah, you're a good fit. Why don't you schedule some time on our calendar here? And here is where we are plugging in that Calendly UUID, which is the universally unique identification token, which is in plain English, just an ID that is created for every Calendly event and it is unique to that event. So this is the perfect identification tag for us to perform future automations. If we ever want to know, hey, how did that particular Calendly event go? And where did that lead come from? Well, we want to be able to trace all of that back to its point of origin, which we are going to be able to do by saving that Calendly UUID inside of our form automation. So let's get to work. Popping back now into Fillout, I'm going to start with my form and I'm going to call this Calendly integration form. And continue. All right, so first I wanna have my general questions. And so since I'm already integrated with my Airtable, you'll see that I have them here on the left side of my screen. I wanna know what my first name is, I wanna know what my last name is of the person filling this out anyway. And of course, I wanna also know their email address and the question, or rather the answer to question one. So here we go. Note that I can resize these things. I can shrink them down. I can play with them and make them look nicer on the form. There is a lot of customization available here with Fillout that I don't want to get into because it's not the heart or the point of this video per se. Now, once I'm happy with the way that this first page looks, I'm going to go on to my next page. So in order to do that, I can add a page down here at the bottom part of my form. And here's where I want to allow them to book time on my calendar. Now, please note, and of course, it's telling us right here, that this is going to be an advanced feature that requires a premium plan with Calendly. So look at their pricing. Current pricing is constantly changing as they make upgrades to the platform. But for now, this is going to be on one of those paid accounts. So it will require that you upgrade if you want to get this advanced functionality. In my opinion, it's an easy decision to make. We use this a lot in our business, but you'll have to make that call for yourself. All right. So now whatever the name of this page is, I get to choose. I'll call this page scheduling. It doesn't really matter except for the architecture of the form, and then I'll move on. Now I need to connect this to Calendly, which I haven't done yet. Obviously, it's a brand new widget, so I better click in here and get that connection going. So I've already connected my Calendly for other forms, but I have to choose the specific event that I want this to reference for this particular form. Note that we've got a bunch of different types of events inside of Gap Consulting with a bunch of different people. And so I need to make sure that I choose the right one. I'm gonna choose one that I know doesn't get used a lot. It's my built to scale feedback. This is for me personally, so I'm not gonna be messing with anybody's calendar while I'm demoing this out, which is perfect. All right, now we can choose our Calendly prefills if we want to bring in the email address or the name. And you might be surprised to know that we actually have access to this information from the previous page. So because they already gave us their name and their email, we can actually save them a step by filling it in for them. We can say page, first name, space, and then let's bring in last name. Drop that in right here. My space didn't seem to register. Can I get a space between these things? There we go. Now, same thing with, oh, I put that in the name. Or the email I need to copy or cut and paste. That's better. Let's get it down here instead. We can bring the email address up here, which is what I should have done. Note that we have to go to the source of that data. So for us, it came from what is called page. And that's just the default name of the first page that we built here. So I'm drilling into page and I'm bringing in that answer. Now I don't care about the date of this thing. I don't care. I'm gonna let them make that selection, so we're gonna just leave that up to them. See if I can fix this one last time. It seems to be finicky because I did my copy paste. I'm just gonna scrap it and start over. I should have gotten it right the first time. Let's go with first name and last name. Get in there, and we should be good to go. All right. So now I'm filling this information out. The person has a direct integration with my Calendly. Everything that shows up here is generally produced from Calendly, meaning that whatever availability I've set for my particular event, and of course, whatever availability I have on my calendar, because this event is linked to my calendar, is going to be reflected here. This is going to prevent duplicate creations of meetings, and it's going to make sure that no one is double booked and overlapping. So we're good to go with this. They get to pick their time, and we're almost done. Now, the last piece I want to add here is that we could set some conditional logic in this form. This is getting a little advanced, but we could say, listen, maybe we've got a few different options here on the question one. Actually, let me plop some options in. I'm going to drop into Airtable and fill out some options. So we're asking a question. Maybe it's like, you know, what's your favorite ice cream? They might say vanilla. They might get to pick chocolate, and they might get to pick pistachio. I think I spelled that right. Let's go ahead and save it. Now, if we go back to fill out and we refresh our connection, that data should be getting pulled in automatically into our system here. In order to refresh, we need to go back to our connection here and simply refresh that connection, pull in new data, and that should be bringing in now the information as you see right here. Now, maybe for us, if they answer pistachio, we say, actually, you're not a good fit for us and we don't want to schedule a consultation. But if you say vanilla or chocolate, then you're a good fit and you're going to be directed to the scheduling page. So in that condition, we can actually navigate or choose how they navigate the form based on their answers from one page to the next. Now, in order to impact that conditional logic, we're going to go down to the bottom right corner of our screen and click on the logic symbol right here. And this is where we can decide how the actual flow from one page of the form to the next is going to work. Well, we haven't actually created the final page. We have this ending page here that we should give some attention to before we move on. So maybe this ending page in a linear flow says, hey, thank you, you just filled out our Calendly application. You've scheduled with us. We got all the information we need. But maybe we need another ending page as well. We can add a second ending page. This is ending two. And in this particular case, we might say something like, you know, based on the fact that you like pistachio ice cream, we shouldn't move forward. Sorry. So let's just fill that out. Based on the fact that you like pistachio, this won't be a fit. Now, we don't want these people to ever get to our Calendly page. We can control that with our logic here. And this is where we're going to end in or set up our different branches. So I can add a branch here that says, actually, you're going to go right to ending two under certain conditions. What are those conditions? Well, if you like pistachio. So from the first page, if you answered question one equal to pistachio, again, I'm guessing at that spelling, then you're going to be taken directly to ending two and you will not be asked to schedule with us. But any other answer than pistachio is going to allow you to go up to the scheduling link and then you're going to get the other ending page. So now that we've built in the page logic, let's see how this thing works. Now, one last thing that I haven't mapped yet is actually on the scheduling page. Inside of this element, I have not connected this to Airtable yet. So I'm going to select a field and try to drop this into the Calendly UUID. I'm not sure, full transparency, I haven't tested this. I don't know if it's going to plug in the Calendly UUID or if it's going to plug in the date time of the event that was scheduled. So we're gonna have to test it out. That being said, I do know that it is possible to get the Calendly UUID if we are using Make. So we're gonna look at that in a slightly more advanced example as well. But let's for now publish this, drill into our published form. Let's go ahead and pop it open and fill it out. And this is the nice thing about Fillout. It's so, so quick. It's already integrated with Airtable. So I'll fill this out. This is gonna be John Smith and he is at john@example.com. And he likes pistachio. Well, where's he going? Nowhere. He's going to our end page that says, based on the fact you like pistachio, this isn't working for us. But what if we filled this out in a different way, right? We could go in, fill this out with any answer other than pistachio, Emily Doe, Emily at example, and she likes vanilla. And then she gets taken to our Calendly page, which is mapped up to our calendar. She can select whatever day she likes to meet. Let's say 9 a.m. on this date and time. Notice that it's already filled out here, except we accidentally included her last name in the email prefill. Ugh, that's why you don't copy paste. I made a mistake there. But in long story short, she's scheduling this up and she's gonna go ahead and fill this out. What's gonna be sent to Airtable? That's the big question. Let's flip over to Airtable now to see. Now, first things first, we see John filled out. We see Emily filled out. That Calendly UUID did not get filled out correctly, so something is getting dropped. But what I want to show you is if we flip into make.com, we can actually build a more advanced integration with this information. So let's drop into make. From here, I'm going to say create new scenario, and fill out is an option here for us. Let's find it. I've been invited. You might have to go through this process of getting set up, which is not hard to do. Now we're going to watch new responses from our form. And in this case, I'm going to add a new hook. Let's build a new one. And we're going to go step by step, pick out our form. We have not named this form, in fact. So, oh no, we did. It was called our Calendly integration form. Let's go ahead and make that selection and click save. So now anytime anybody fills this form out, we are going to receive that information here. I'm going to run it. And I'm going to fill out the form so that you can see the information that we get from this. Let's go back now into our fill out form. Here's a new example, and this one might be filled out by Justin. Test, running out of names. Justin@example.com. And Justin likes chocolate. Next. Justin schedules, picks a time. Next. And here it is. Of course, we need to fix the prefill there. We'll get to it in time. We schedule the event. What matters is what make is going to pick up here, and we can look at this information in our bundle. So notice that the submission ID that's coming right here is a unique identifier that we can use, and we can also drill in and look at our Calendly data. Here is that universally unique ID from Calendly, the UUID, that is unique for that event. So we can bring this information into Airtable, into Smart Suite, wherever we're storing it, but we can record it at the same time that this whole application is filled out. This gives us a great way to move forward and consolidate all our data in a way that we couldn't do when we had two separate processes. I know we went kind of fast in this video, so if you have any questions, do drop them below and we'll do our best to answer. But in the meantime, keep on building.